Hey, it's Kaylee. This lesson is about different things we can measure in statistics. It will be helpful if you've already completed the lesson called Statistical Questions and Dot Plots. All right, let's get started. In the lesson Statistical Questions and Dot Plots, we had asked the question, how tall are basketball players? And we collected data and made a dot plot to help us analyze our data. By looking at the peaks and clusters on our dot plot, we were able to come up with a general answer to our question. We said, most basketball players are about 80 inches. But what if we want a more specific answer? A measure of center is a single number used to describe a set of data. For example, let's say we have 5 bags of candy, but the bags don't have the same number of candy pieces in each bag. We want to know how many pieces of candy come in a bag. If we count the pieces in each bag, our data will look like 6, 4, 3, 5, and 7. So now that we've collected our data, we need to organize it. Remember, we do that by ordering our data from least to greatest. Now we can always make a dot plot to help us visualize our data, or we can use some math. Instead of coming up with a general answer to our statistical question, we can use a measure of center calculation to find a single number that will describe our data. Measures of center include the mean and the median. Let's start with the mean. The mean, also called the average of a set of data, is the sum of all the data values added together and then divided by the total number of data values in the set. So let's find the mean of our data set. This will answer our statistical question, how many pieces of candy on average are in a bag. So first we write the sum of our data in the numerator and we divide by the number of data values. So on top we have 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. And on the bottom we have 5 because we have 5 numbers in our data set. So in the numerator our sum comes out to be 25. And 25 divided by 5 is 5. So we can say the mean or the average is 5. A good way to check your work is to keep these facts about the mean in mind. Since the mean represents an average value within a data set, the mean can never be larger than the largest value in the data set. This is because all the other numbers in the data set are smaller and they bring the average down or lower than the greatest value. And the opposite is also true. The mean can never be less than the least number in the data set. Since all the other data values are greater, they bring the average up. Now let's talk about the median. The median represents the middle value of an ordered data set. For the median, it is super important that you have ordered your data in numerical order, like least to greatest. Let's calculate the median of our data set. I do this by systematically crossing out the outside numbers and working my way into the center, like this. And the middle value is the median. So for our data, we can say the median is 5. But what if I had 6 data values in my set? Now when I work my way into the middle, I find 2 values. So now to find the median value of my data set, I have to find the mean of these 2 middle values. So I put the sum on the top, 5 plus 6, and 2 in the bottom, since I'm only finding the average of these 2 data values. So I have 11 over 2, or 5.5. So for this data set, my median would be 5.5. Anytime a data set has an even number of values, you will need to find the average of those middle numbers to find the median. Now there's another important thing to look at when we are analyzing data. The mode is the data value that occurs the most frequently in the data set. When we were looking at dot plots, the peak would represent the mode. For this data set, the mode is 81 because it appears 4 times in the data, which is more than any other data value appears. If we look at our original data from the 5 bags of candy, we would say there is no mode since none of the data values appear more than once. But in this data set, when I have 6 bags of candies, we do have a mode. The data value 6 occurs twice, which is more than any of the other data values. But a data set can have more than one mode. If this was our data, we would have 2 modes. Both 4 and 6 occur more than the other data values. A data set can have multiple modes as long as they occur with the same frequency or the same amount of times. Now that we have looked at the measures of center, let's talk about the measure of variability. The measure of variability is a single number to describe the spread of a data set. When we look at dot plots, we think of the spread of data as going from the smallest number to the largest number. But we can calculate a single number to tell us how much spread there really is. The range is a measure of spread. It is the difference between the greatest data value and the least data value. If we look at our data from the candy bags, we find the range. We take our largest data value, 7, and we subtract our smallest data value, 3. So we get 7 minus 3 equals 4. The range of our data is 4. So let's answer our question. How many pieces of candy are in a bag? And we can say the average number of pieces per bag is 5. Great work learning the arithmetic of statistics. Practice what you've learned by playing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey.